Today it's about the accuracy of temperature measurement using RTDs, class A, class B, wiring technologies. There are some things to discuss. Hi, I'm Dietmar. I'm senior application engineer for temperature measurement at Endress+Hauser. I'm working in the business for some decades and I want to share my expertise with you. The accuracy of the PT100 sensor itself is written down in an international standard, the international norm 6751. In this, you will find three classes of accuracy. The first one, or the last one as you want, is the so-called class B. All of these accuracy classes look the same way. The best possible accuracy is around 0 degrees Celsius, 32 degrees Fahrenheit, the temperature of melting ice. And from this point, there are funnels opening with an accepted tolerance. For example, here at class B, at 100 degrees Celsius, it's around plus minus 3/4 of a degree. The next one, obviously, should be class A, which is, yeah, more or less double as accurate. Again, we have this funnel opening, and you see at 100 degrees, we are around 0.4 degrees plus minus as an accepted tolerance. The customers ask for something better for many, many years, but you see, there was no letter left. So what should the people who have written down the standard do? Yeah, they introduced a class AA. And this is exactly 3 times better than the class B, again with this funnel construction. And you see here we are around plus minus 0.4 degrees in these kind of applications. Additional to this, it's very important how to connect the sensor. If you just connect the two wires of the resistance, you have an influence of the line resistance itself. And when the lines are made of a metal, these lines also react on temperature changes. And so it's really not recommended at all to use a PT100 measurement with this two-wire technology, because the resistance of the wire will destroy the accuracy of your measurement. A better solution is the so-called three-wire connection. And here it works like this, the transmitter is measuring sometimes or constantly what is the line resistance in the moment. Because here in this loop, we are measuring 2 times of the line resistance only. And so it can compensate this from the result, which is measured in the second loop, which is 2 times of the line resistance and the sensor itself. This works good for many applications if all of these line resistances are really absolutely the same at any time. And this cannot be guaranteed for very, very long cables, for mineral insulated cables, extending a certain length, and for changes of the terminal resistance, if the screws are really set with the same force. And so the best method is the four-wire connection. In this, the transmitter is working in a different way, so it totally compensates the influences of any line resistance. They must not be the same any longer, it doesn't matter. It's totally compensated, so the highest accuracy can be reached using the four-wire connection. If you think that is all you need to know about the accuracy of a RTD measurement, that's not true. The biggest mistakes can be made during the planning phase. See the next video. Hope you like it. If yes, watch out for the next video of this series and leave us a comment, a like, or share.